Okay, so these are the commands. Okay, these are the commands. So bin bash, so this is going to call the interpreter, bash interpreter, because this is going to be a bash script. Okay, if you are writing a Python script, you have to give bin /python. So that time the compiler will come to know which interpreter it has to call to run this script. Okay, so for all the Linux machines, this is going to be common. Okay, this is going to be common for all the Linux machines. Only thing is that if you are using Ubuntu here, instead of yum, what do you have to give? apt-get. So what all the commands are there for that particular Linux flavor, you have to give only those commands. Rest of the things will remain same. The logic is same. Only thing is that if some, for example, Ubuntu doesn't understand yum repository, yum module, for that you have to give apt-get. So that we will see going forward. So for now we'll just use yum, because we're going to provision we're going to provision the Linux flavor, which is the first one given by AWS. Okay, so you can either paste this completely here. If you don't want to paste it, if you want to take it as an keep there in the file and take the input from there, you can do that also, because this way is the better way. Why is this way the better way? Because if you want to now change something, just you have to just save it automatically. It's going to know that from where it has to pick up the file. Okay, if you put it here, every time you need to change it here also, then right? So we'll just take the input as a file. So we'll just save this file. Okay, let's save this file on my desktop itself, and we'll just name it as auto scaling automation. Okay, so keep it as a text file or keep it as a bat file, both are fine. Okay, just keep it as a text file for now. Text file will be easy, because if you keep it as a text file, you'll be able to open it directly. Otherwise you need to have that software which is known as Notepad++, which I am using right now, in order to open this file. Okay, so come here, so click on choose, go back to the desktop, and in the desktop select that file. Okay, this one. Okay, I just selected it, autoscaling.txt. Click on add storage, normal procedures, 8 of 8. For I need two of them. Okay, for now I need two of them, so there is a way to have two of them. So file is already attached. Let's go back here, both with this name, we'll say auto scaling okay, instances. So just group them, come back here. You can use either the what you have already used yesterday, the one which we created, in that you have to open port HTTP, HTTPS and SSH. So these three, port 80, port 22, port 443 should be enabled. Okay, this is all same. Let's go to launch, and we have a any key you can select, whichever is there for you. Just create Arun, I mean just have this Ansible key. Okay, okay, no, create partners, let's just have this Arun key. So now we'll just wait for some time until these instances come online. Okay, so now you can see both are running. Okay, I'll just hit refresh once. So both are running. So let's see if our command has passed or not. Okay, what command we have given, the automation command. For that, just take the public IP address, put it in your browser, or take the DNS name. You can see this is working. So hello AWS class, what does this mean? This means that it has started, assumed it as a root user, then installed the HTTPD server, after that switched on the service or started the HTTPD service, and then put this small HTML code in that HTML file, index.html file. Okay, so now let's just check another one. So if it has run on one, it will run on another also. Why? Because I created the same template, two EC2 instances, right? With the same template. Okay, so you can see another one also is working. So now you can, by default, either you use the DNS name what we have given for each and every instance. When you shut down this instance, start it again, that time this is going to change, because this is the IP address, public IP address, 34.201 is the public IP address only. Okay, so I have told I have created the script in such a way that even if I restart this system, I should not feel any downtime for the application, or HTTPD server should automatically come up. Okay, let's just try to restart it. Or okay, let's try to restart a instance. This is IPv4 I've created. IPv6 will have 8 blocks. Okay, so now this thing is restarting. If I now go to this IP address, it should not show me anything. Basically, it's just connecting. Okay, if it's just connecting, it's not showing anything.
We are restarting the machine, and if there was
okay. Now you can see that it has restarted the system, and the application came back online. Okay, application came back online even after restarting. So what happens if you are restarting a system, if you have not put this check config there and you are restarting the system, if you are just deleting this restarting, it is not going to run it once again. It is not going to run these commands once again. This command is just to tell it that it needs to keep the check config always on. Okay. Now if you make certain changes in your user script, then you restart it, then it is going to run the new script. Okay, if you are not making any changes on the script and you are restarting it, it is not going to pick the new that script, run the script once again. Okay, so any changes, or else if you now want to, there is a way to change the user script also. So if you go to action and instance state, so you can change the, we want to change user data. Okay, this is what we put there, right? So now it will tell you that in order to edit this, you have to first stop the instance. You cannot restart. You have to first stop, then start the instance, then only new things will be reflected. Understood? You understood? So that is the way it is. Okay. So now this is what we put in that file. So it has copied entire thing into its user script. Okay. Okay. That's the thing. So now we'll just keep instance 1 and 2. Just change the name to instance auto-scaling 1 and auto-scaling 2, because this way we'll be able to sort of track it properly.
The modification kinds are like we have linking this. Like in Drupal, if we once do it, it's done. That's how it should be for us. After creating it also,
for this instance or any instance for that matter, you can change anything. If you want to change the role, what you have attached, IAM role, if you want to change the termination protection, if you want to change the user data, change the shutdown behavior, change the family type of this instance from T2 to something else, okay, you can do that. Okay, instance screenshot. So I mean, there are a lot of new things. See, this is a new thing, get system log and get this, it was not there earlier. So they add new things also, they add new thing also on the fly. That is what continuous deployment is. They do the continuous deployment even if we don't find any downtime. If they have to provide new things or new upgradation to their software, this is the software. Okay, at 11 o'clock it is like this, at 12 o'clock it might change. And for even if you are using from 11 to 12, you will not even feel it that there has been any new deployment. So that means new version of the application came into picture without you even noticing it. Okay, that is what continuous deployment is. That is what companies are trying to achieve. Okay, companies are, so as of now only 4 to 5 companies in the world are doing continuous deployment. The Google, Facebook, Amazon, and there is one more company, Microsoft also. They also do the you will never ever find this maintenance window or something, site under maintenance on these websites ever. Okay, that is what continuous deployment. But they are changing things every now and then. They are changing things without you even noticing it. You are seeing the new version every single day. Understood? So having said that, so networking also, now you can change security groups, you can attach a network interface, you can change this source destination check. I will tell you later what this is while we go to the VPC section. Okay, so you can manage your IP addresses. CloudWatch monitoring is enable detailed monitoring. If you have if you forgot to enable detailed monitoring while creating it, you can do it here also. If you want to disable detailed monitoring, you can disable. What is detailed monitoring? 1 minute monitoring of the CloudWatch. Okay, and by default there's going to be standard monitoring, which is 5 minutes. Okay, so add alarms, edit alarms, everything now you can do from this console only. It was not always like this. It was that you had to go somewhere and then change it there. But now they have given everything. This is known as the user experience. Okay, that is what they are basically doing. Okay, so now that we have created this, let's go and create the auto scaling group. So before we create the auto scaling group, what should we need? If we want any server to run to get automatically provisioned, we want it to have the same application what was already running. So for that, what should we do? Image will create. Okay, image is going to help us because in auto scaling group there are two things. One is the launch configuration, other one is the auto scaling group. Okay, launch configuration is what instance you want to launch. You can either give a new instance or the one which you have already created image for. So now let's just do one thing. Let's create an image, okay, of this instance. Go to image, create image. We'll give the name as let's give the application name, okay? Hello, AWS class app is on this instance. Okay, so description also should be same. If you want, tell it to no reboot. It is not going to reboot the instance, this instance from where I'm going to create the image for. Okay, let's just say no reboot. Okay, and everything just keep whatever. If you want to change something here, if you want new instance to have more memory, the hard disk is EBS, you can do it. If you want to, it had to have new volume type, you can do that also here. Okay, for now let's just have all defaults. Click on save. Okay, so now go back to the AMIs. So this is the AMI what we created. So now it will take some time to create this AMI. So let it first create this AMI. We'll come back to it on what we have to do after this. So before let it create, so I'll just come quickly to auto scaling group and show you what it is. Okay, so auto scaling group is launch configuration, first thing. So you need to first create a launch configuration for the auto scaling group to know what it has to do if some event comes in. Okay, so launch configuration is very important. Okay, without this you cannot create an auto scaling group. If I directly go to auto scaling group, okay, it is create auto scaling group. So it is going to tell me launch either do the launch configuration or the template which is already there. Okay, if I say create a new, then I have to first, this is the important thing to do. Okay, without this it will not even get to know what it has to do if some event comes in. Okay, this is the way to tell auto scaling group that this is what you have to do. Okay, so launch configuration, it will now take us to the same page. If I directly open the launch configuration page, it will again take me to the to this page only. Okay, so let's go back to EC2, go to launch configuration. You will see same thing will come up again, what came up from there. Okay, it has just redirected us to that. So here what I have to select is either new instance, if I want to have a new instance only new instance, same thing like we when we provision EC2, same thing, that is what the configuration is. Otherwise if I want it to have my own image, okay, so this is my own image getting created now. Okay, once it's done we will use this only. Okay, let's quickly go and check if it is done or not. Go back to this, go to EC2 and open my this AMIs. Okay, so this is still getting created. Okay, let it create. Once it is in the status would say something available or something. Okay, once it is in that form, that on that time only we'll be able to use it. Okay. Okay, now the image is available. Let's just go back to the launch configuration and select this AMI, my AMI. Okay, so this is what my AMI is. So it is EBS backed. This was the name of what I gave it. Okay, you can either give this or you can give this AMI ID. AMI ID is unique also globally. Okay, if you give this also, but this only coders do in the code. Okay, to identify this instance. Okay, so for now let's just create this. Go back to, we'll tell it to create the same one. Okay, now give a name of the launch configuration. Okay, so we can give any name. So I'll just say this is my hello AWS launch configuration. Okay, if you want to purchase a spot instance also at that point in time only, you can select this. You can tell it either create an on demand or create a spot instance if some event comes into picture. Okay, so if you want to reduce your cost also at the time, and if you want, if the traffic increases, so you can do it from here also. Okay, so you can tell that what maximum price you can pay for this. So right now they are saying that 0.0035 is the cost in availability 1A. If you are paying something, either this one or more than this, if the price matches, you will get it at that point in time. Okay. So IAM role is something, I don't know if we are told this in the class, right? So this is that if you want to give this instance any access to S3 or any other resource, okay, for that we don't, for now we don't need it, okay, we will not do it. So by default, standard monitoring will be enabled for all the instances. If you want to enable a detailed monitoring, you can do it from here. So but notice that detailed monitoring is what, it is chargeable. Okay, so because I have created an AMI of my entire application which was already running, so it is going to provision the same thing. But if you want to custom create a new file, okay, new this for this instance, for example, you want to change something in this application, so it is going to run that new one then. So new one will come into, whenever new instance comes up, so new user data will be, it is going to take. Okay, for now we're not going to tell it to do anything because we already have created the image of our instance which has the application up and running. So it just has to copy the entire thing and give us the entire thing. Okay, so everything else should be default, don't change anything else, just go to next. Here again same windows you'll see security groups. We want to change for this instance or keep it the same one, you can do that also. Now the point here is that if this is a front facing instance, for example user facing instance, for that HTTP and HTTPS should be open, that port should be open, then only they will be able to log in, I mean use this application. Okay, I've shown you that yesterday also how you can do that, right?
Yes, we
have
not seen HTTPS.
HTTPS and HTTP is same.
No, said we have to
put
a security, no.
That we don't have. We don't have that security. That companies will be having that security certificate. Okay. Okay. And now I have created this. I can either click there only to go to the launch auto scaling group, or come back here and then select create an auto scaling group based on that. Okay. So let's just give the name. So it has by default taken, this was our launch configuration name, right? So now we can create the auto scaling group also. ASG. Okay, so how many instance do I want this group to have, minimum 2 or 3, how many? No, for example this is this group, so how many instance at one point in time should be there? If I say 2, then it is going to create 2 instances at that point in time. Okay, so let's just create 2 for now for you to understand, or 1. This is going to be VPC is going to be default because we, as of now, we have not taken VPC class. Okay, so subnet is again like in which subnet you want to put this availability zone, this instance into. Okay, so let's just put it in any availability zone, or else if you want to put this in all the availability zones, it's going to take anything from there. Okay, so this is not an issue. So now this is going to be highly redundant instance, this is not going to go down even if 5 to 6 availability zone goes down. Okay, 5 availability zone goes down, still you will be able to see the application. Okay, so now load balancing is, if you have already created a load balancer, what we created yesterday, if you want this to be connected to that, you can enable it here. Okay, receive traffic from the load balancer, and you here, since we do not have any load balancer as of now, it will show you the name of that load balancer also here. Okay, so for now we don't have load balancer, so just get it like this. Okay, health check grace period is again the same thing that what we have seen yesterday in the threshold, how it's going to see that if the instance is there or not. If the instance goes down, it is going to wait for these many seconds for it to run new instance. Okay, we are going to reduce it to 7 seconds. Okay, for a lab. Okay, so it's if the instance goes down or something happens, it is going to wait for 7 seconds for it to run a new instance. Okay, that is what this is. So instance protection, for now keep it scale and keep everything default. Okay, so what is instance if protect from scale in set, newly launched instances will be protected from the scale in by default. Okay, scaling in, scaling out, we will see later what that is. Okay, that is going to be your task also. I normally give that for people to explore. Okay, this is going to be your assignment. Okay, so now here using scaling policies to adjust the capacity of this group. So this is what is, this is where you have to select in what event, in what case you want this auto scaling group to come into picture. Okay, one thing is, if you tell it that keep this group at its initial size, this would mean that even if one instance goes down, it will automatically launch a new instance and then keep that group size as 2. Understood what I'm trying to say? So for now, what we'll do is we'll just keep this group to the initial size only, the 2-1 which we have already given it. Okay, and we told it just have 2 instances up and running all the time. Okay, let's just do this way first. Keep this to initial size. Come to notifications. You can add notification. This is again going to be something you will be notified to in your email that I have either launched if new instance comes online or new there's a termination or there's a fail to launch, fail to terminate. This is SNS. This is another resource, simple notification service, which we will see going forward. Okay, we'll see that later. So for now, I'll just tell it, okay, give me this. Once this is done, go to next. This is again what? What is this? How to tag these resources with the same name. You can either give the same name. For now, I'll just tell it the name to be automatic launch. Okay, automatic launch. Okay, so now what I have told you that group size should be 2, maximum 2, minimum 2. That means just 2 instances should be up and running all the time, no matter what. If there is traffic, if there is no traffic, I don't care, but 2 instances should be up and running. So my application should be visible. Okay, that is what I have told it for now to do. Okay, so health check is that it's going to wait for 7 seconds. Okay, subnets, it's going to go into these 2 instances are so redundant that now these 2 instances will be in 5 to 6 availability zones. So if now I have given it 6 availability zones, if 5 availability zones goes down for some reason, okay, still my application will be running. Okay, it is so powerful. So detailed monitoring I have not enabled. Okay, instance protection I have not enabled. Instance protection is what? You have seen that in that previous EC2 instance. So now scaling policies, for now I have not told it to do anything based on any event. Just I have told it just keep 2 instances running, up and running, no matter what. Okay, now come to auto scaling group. Okay, so now the auto scaling group will come online. Let's just see what is happening. You can either see the creation logs also, or close this and go back to that auto scaling group dashboard. Here that it's going to show you what is happening with this auto scaling group. Okay, so this is going to be your launch configuration. So auto scaling group is already running. So now let's go back to the EC2 dashboard and see what is happening there, if it is able to create new instances or not. Okay, it should by now be able to provision new instances. Okay, so automatic launch, you are able to see automatic launch here, 1 and 2. So now 2 instances is already up and running, those new 2 instances. Understood that? I did not create these from here, right? How did I create this from? I created it from, yes. So now I'll just delete the previous ones. Okay, I don't need them anymore. I only need something which is in the auto scaling group, because auto scaling group is the instance in auto scaling group are the only instances which are going to automatically come back online. Okay, now that I've deleted these 2 in front of you, now you will see that these will not come back online. But if I delete auto scaling group, any one of the instance or both of them, it is automatically going, it will come back online automatically. Okay, you'll see that. So for now, let's just see if the initial checks are done, if our script is running, if that is able to see the instance. Okay, yeah, see now this is the auto scaling group instance. Okay, because we had created from the AMI of this one. Okay, that is why it is already having the same application up and running for it. Okay, so for now let's just close everything, close this also. Okay, come back to the EC2 dashboard. Let the old ones first come, okay, these are now terminated, okay. Now you will see, even if you wait for 100 seconds or 100 days, these are not going to come back online, okay. So, but if I now delete, this is to delete one instance, okay. So, for example, why I am deleting it? For some reason, if an instance gets deleted, for some reason, it just failed, the host failed and the instance went offline, okay. Same event is going to happen here. See, now I have it is now going to shut down. Now you will see in seconds, in 7 seconds, it is going to provision a new instance automatically, and the name of the instance will be automatic launch. Okay. So now what you can do is you can put these auto scaling group behind the elastic load balancer. Okay, behind the elastic load balancer, and elastic load balancer does what? Distributes the traffic. Okay. So now you see how your application will not be having any downtime now. Understood what is happening. That is why yesterday we did elastic load balancing, and now you can put this behind the elastic load balancer. Instead of giving the EC2, instead of registering the EC2 instances, register the auto scaling group there. Understood? Okay, so that it create. I think it has come online. Let's wait for some 7 seconds or something. It is going to keep the group in two instances state always. Just keep hitting refresh. Okay, so now for this auto scaling group, for some reason it's going to be the default cooldown 300. So we can keep this down also. We can, if you want to change this cooldown period, you can change this also if you want to change. Okay. So for now we have to wait for 300 seconds, means 5 minutes. So it's like 11:25, so 11:30 only it will come into picture. Okay, I just wait until it comes back online. And if you wish to change any of the configuration settings what you have already given, if for some reason you need to change it, so you don't have to create a new auto scaling group for that. You can edit it directly from here. Go to edit, come down, it is going to show you entire thing once again. If you want to change the launch configuration also here, you can change the launch configuration also here for the auto scaling group. So you don't have to create the auto scaling group once again. Whatever you have set already, if based on that you want to now launch a new instance which is not of T2 micro, which is of something M or G or something, okay, so at that point in time you can just create the new launch configuration, attach the launch configuration here. So for now the default cooldown period is 300 seconds. If you want to change it to something, let's just change it to 10 seconds, okay? For new instances, it's going to, for new instances to come online. So save this. So now you can see that the cooldown period has been changed from 300 to 10, okay? By default, it would take 300 seconds, that means 5 minutes. So if I come back to our EC2 instance, so now you can see that new one is already has come online, okay? I just refreshed it, so new one has already come online. So now for some reason, if I delete the first one, I need to just wait for 10 seconds now for it, for a new instance to launch, not 5 minutes now, okay. So now this is the new one, this is the new one, this was the old one which I terminated, this is the new one which came because of that. Now I should possibly see here one more automatic launch. If one more automatic launch is there, that means the new that is going to be the new instance, okay. So one is shutting down and the new will come into effect just fairly in 10 seconds, not more than that. So now you can see, because I had enabled SNS notification, you will see that automatically I got the notification also that something has happened in your account, okay. So it is telling me here that it has launched, a user requested to create, so it has created a new instance. So when the old instance was terminated, so this was the termination for group, okay. So you will get each and every notification what has happened to your auto scaling group also, okay. So this is the best way to keep track of the notifications, okay. So you can see 4 times we have done this auto scaling. So this is here now 1, 2, 3, 4, okay. I've opened all these one. Let's just go back to the auto scaling one and see what has happened. If I click on refresh, okay, so new instance, now 2 instances you are seeing online all the time. Even if anything happens, 2 instances will be online all the time. So this we have captured that, you just keep this group in the initial stage, okay. Let's just delete the old one once again and wait for 10 seconds only, okay. You will see that you will get notification also here based on when new event comes up, okay. You'll see the notifications also. Fine, see now, when it went, so that time only I got this email, and email will consist of that instance terminate, because first instance was terminated, what I did manually. Second thing is, it is said that this instance has completely gone offline. Once it's offline, now it has started the, it will start and you will get one more notification when it's starting. So four notifications you will get based on each event, okay, because we had enabled all four of them. You remember, we enabled all four of them. You can either enable it for just for if new instance comes online, that time only tell me, or if the previous one goes offline, that time only tell me. It again, this is a chargeable service for you see, fifth one you came online, okay. Got email also there. So now it is saying that EC2 instance launch. So now new instance has launched, okay. And this is the instance, this is the account ID, which is mine. And based on this auto scaling group, it has launched that instance. All of that is here, okay. All of that is a start time, end time, what was the cause, and instance was started in response to different in difference between the desired and actual capacity, increasing the capacity from 1 to 2. It found out that instead of 2, it found out only there is only one instance running. So based on that event, it said that because my initial configuration is 2, I have to keep 2 running all the time. That is why I have changed it from 1 to 2. You understood how fast this is happening. A new application is all, because it is an AMI where you created, so new applications already, our application is already running on that instance. Okay. If I hit refresh, so please keep hitting refresh, okay. This doesn't refresh automatically. So don't tell me later that I have created this and then nothing happened on this console. Okay, so now see how fast it is. Understood? Any questions here? There is one more thing here. Now, once you are in the auto scaling group, now if you delete this auto scaling group, it is going to by default delete the instances also which are associated with that auto scaling group. So now you do not have to delete the, because if you try to delete instances manually, what is going to happen? It will keep on adding new instances, right? Based on the auto scaling group. So for that reason, you have to delete the auto scaling group itself. Okay, so when you are doing this by yourself, so please delete the auto scaling group, don't delete the instance and shut down. When you come back tomorrow, it will be automatically running. Okay, so delete this auto scaling group. Click here, delete the auto scaling group. That time, that way, what it's going to do, it is going to delete the, it's going to delete the instances behind this auto scaling group also. I have deleted the auto scaling group. Launch configuration, you can keep it. Anyways, it's not going to do any event because auto scaling group is not there. So launch configuration is related to auto scaling group. Auto scaling group depends upon the launch configuration. Okay. So I have just deleted the auto scaling group. I have not deleted the launch configuration. Launch configuration name was this. It will be there only. I have created more, I think 3, 4, 5. Okay. This is already there. This is, there will not be any charges for that. If I come back to EC2 dashboard, I should see everything shutting down. Okay. Okay. Everything is shutting down now, right? Automatically. So these two were up and running. These two are now shutting down automatically. Understood what is happening here. Okay. Any questions here? So now for auto scaling group is free to create, but the instances which it creates are chargeable, right? So you'll be only you'll get charges based on the instances only, what you provision based. So otherwise auto scaling group is free service. Okay, so that is it for auto scaling group.